An official from the Philippine province of Albay reports the spread of COVID-19 among Mayon evacuees has been controlled. In an interview with Teleradio Serbisyo, the provincial disaster office chief said the infections are isolated cases. At least three residents staying in evacuation centers contracted COVID-19. Officials assured the public they are regularly conducting disease surveillance. As of June 26, around 5,700 families remain in evacuation centers due to the unrest of Mayon volcano, which remains under alert level 3.
One person is reported dead and 11,000 families are affected by the recent floods in northern Mindanao. Torrential rains triggered the massive flooding in the region. The Civil Defense Office says 17 families remain in evacuation areas. The local government has distributed around 2 million pesos in aid to affected residents.
Meanwhile, preparations are underway for the second State of the Nation address of President Marcos on July 24. The House of Representatives on Thursday held a meeting with concerned agencies to discuss security and other preparations. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority says it will deploy over 1,300 personnel to manage traffic. It is also eyeing to implement zipper lanes in parts of Commonwealth Avenue leading to the lower house in Batasan Hills, Quezon City.
As of now, based on our preparation, wala pa kaming decision na isasara ang Commonwealth. But of course, we encourage, we suggest na sa ating mga motorista that during the zona, doon na sila magdaan sa mga alternate route at bibigyan naman namin yan later on kung saan ang mga alternate route.
Other news, a suspected Japanese criminal who was deported from the Philippines is arrested for allegedly masterminding a robbery in Kyoto. Kyoto Imamura was among four suspects caught in the Philippines and then sent back to Japan early this year. They're believed to be senior members of the so-called Luffy Gang, which ran scams from the Philippines. The gang is accused of being involved in hundreds of criminal incidents across Japan, including robberies, since 2021. One of those robberies ended in the murder of a 90-year-old woman.
Switching gears now, beloved action hero Indiana Jones embarks on his final adventure in Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny. It stars Tok Tiong Chavez about the film's significant impact on their lives.
Harrison Ford says Indiana Jones in the Dial of Destiny celebrates something that he truly believes in. The actor, who's turning 81 this July, first played the archaeologist and explorer action hero in 1981.
It's a beautiful movie. Best seen in a movie theater. You get a chance to experience your common humanity. Really, that's what we're missing in our lives. Is this common humanity. This movie is about that. It's kind of cool.
The movie is considered as the final chapter of the original Indiana Jones story, and its cast honored its importance from the get-go. British actress-writer Phoebe Waller-Bridge plays Helena, who unexpectedly joins Indiana Jones in his latest adventures.
In being part of it, what surprised you the most?
You have to actually go on the adventure when you're in an adventure film like Indiana Jones. I think possibly because it's so real, we shot in real locations, so many of the action sequences were real, and so you experience so much of it. I came out the other end feeling like a lot of that stuff had actually happened to me. But also just that the passion and the heart, you know, you see these huge movies that have huge success, and then you meet the kind of group of people that either originated it or are carrying on, picking up the torch. The passion for this character, the passion for the film to create the exact same atmosphere, it's very moving.
Veteran actor Mads Mikkelsen, who plays the movie's villain, says that in working on the project, he was aware that he had two responsibilities.
When you play a character like this, you're serving the film. If you play the main character, the film is serving you. It's two very different things. So we are very aware in a film like this that we somehow throw the ball up there for Harrison to hit. Meaning, but that we serve a purpose for the film. And then we'll have to find our characters within that as well.
Its all-star cast includes Antonio Banderas, Boyd Holbrook, Jeanette Renee Wilson, and some familiar characters from past Indiana Jones movies. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.